Hey guys, I am Ritul Chawda and today we are going to have a discussion about project management tools. All the topics will be explained by me and my colleagues. So let's start by understanding the term project management. So what is project management? Project management is the practice of initiating, planning, executing, controlling and closing the work of a team to achieve specific goals and meet specific success criteria at a specific time. The primary challenge of a project management is to achieve all the project goals within the given constraint in the time period. Project management is the development, marketing and sale of a product to a customer. Product management starts from when a product is merely just an idea and continues all the way through the life cycle of a product, including when the product arrives in the customer's home. So why it is used? Project management greatly reduces the risk of budget overruns. Project management allows to effective change management and makes it less of a complex task. Quality is continuously managed, more so than ever. It is important to reduce quality results. Project management helps to identify, manage and control quality. So the elements of project management are strategic alignment. Project management is important because it ensures what is being delivered is right and what delivers real value against the business opportunity. Every client has strategic goals and the project that we do for them advance these goals. Project management is important because it ensures that the user is architecting project properly so that they fit well within the broader context of a client's strategic frameworks. Good project management ensures that the goals of a project closely align with the strategic goals of a business. Second is leadership. Project management is important because it brings leadership and direction to projects. Without project management, a team can be like a ship without a rudder, moving but without direction, control or purpose. Leadership allows and enables a team to do their best work. Project management serves the team but also ensures clear lines of accountability. With a project manager in a place, there is no confusion about who's in charge and in control of whatever going on in a project. Project managers enforce process and keep everyone on the team in the line too, because ultimately they carry responsibility for whether the project fails or succeeds. Third, clear focus and objective. Project management ensures there is a proper plan for executing strategic goals. When project management is left to a team to work out by themselves, you will find teamwork without proper briefs. Lack of focus can have vague or nebulous objectives and leave them to the team not quite sure what they are supposed to do or by doing or why. As project manager, we position ourselves to prevent such a situation and drive the timely accomplishment of tasks by breaking up a project into tasks for our teams. Fourth, realistic project planning. Project management ensures proper expectations are set and what have been delivered, by when and for how much. Without proper management, budget estimation and project delivery timeline can be set that are over-ambitious or lacking in analogous estimating insight for similar project. Ultimately, this means without good project management, project can deliver late or over budget. Fifth, quality control. Project management is important because it ensures the quality of whatever is being delivered consistently hits the mark. Projects are also usually under enormous pressure to complete it. Without a dedicated project manager who has a support and buy-in executive management, tasks are underestimated, schedules tightened and process rushed. The result is been badly outputs. Dedicated project management ensures that no one does project and on time and resources are not delivered. But also the output is quality are tested on each and every stage. Risk management. Risk management is critically the project process. The temptation is just to sweep the under carpet, never talk them to the client and hope for the best. But having robust process around the identification, management and mitigation of risk is what the help prevent risk from the becoming issues. Good project management practice requires project managers to carefully analyze all potential risks to project, qualify them, develop a mitigation plan against them and contingently plan and all them to materialize. 7. Orderly process. It ensures that the proper project process is followed throughout the project life cycle. Proper planning and process makes a massive difference as the team who knows does what and when and how. Project management matters well because Without an orderly and easily understood process, companies risk failure, attrition, and employee trust, and resource wastage. 8. Continuous oversight. Status reporting might sound bold and unnecessary, and if everything going to plan, it can just feel like documentation for documentation's sake. But continuous project insight ensures that project is getting tracked properly against the original plan and is critical to ensure that the project stays on track. 9. Subject matter expertise. Subject matter expertise means that they can live and have intelligent and informed conversation with clients, team stakeholders, and suppliers. They are well equipped to the hub of communication on project, ensures that the project flows between different teams and phases of work. Nothing gets forgotten about overcook. Management learning and success failure. This process is valuable for a set of documentation that becomes a record of dos and don'ts, do's and don'ts, going forward, enabling the organization to learn from failure and success. Without this learning, team will keep often moving, making and mistake, time and again. Retrospectives and great documentation to us at a project kickoff meeting to remind the time about failure, such as underestimating project, and success, such as briefing benefits of a solid process, or the importance of keeping time sheet reporting up to date.
So next is traditional approach. Traditional approach is considered generally for large scale projects. Traditional approach includes the five following steps: initiating, planning and design, monitoring and controlling, closing and execution. First is initiating. The initiating process determines the nature and scope of the project. The initiating stage should include a plan that encompasses the following areas, like analyzing the business needs or business requirements in measurable goals, reviewing of the current operation, financial analysis of the costs and benefits including a budget, stakeholder analysis including users and support personnel for the project, project charter including costs, tasks, deliverables and schedules. Next is planning and design. After the initiation stage, the project is planned to an appropriate level of details. Project planning generally consists of following things: determining how to plan, developing the scope statement, selecting the planning team, identifying the activities needed to complete deliverables and networking the activities in the logical sequence, estimating the resource requirements, time and cost for the activities, developing the schedule and budget, risk planning, and gaining formal approval to begin work. Next is execution. The execution phase ensures that the deliverables of project management plan are executed accordingly. This phase involves proper allocation, coordination, and management of human resources and any other resources such as materials and budgets. The output of this phase is the project deliverables. The fourth step is monitoring and controlling. Monitoring and controlling consists of those processes performed to observe project execution so that potential problems can be identified in a timely manner and corrective action can be taken when necessary to control the execution of the project. Monitoring and controlling includes following steps: measuring the ongoing project activities, monitoring the project against the project constraints and management plan and the project performance baseline, identifying corrective actions to address issues and risks properly. The final step in this traditional approach is closing. Closing includes the formal acceptance of the project and the ending, therefore. Administrative activities include the archiving of the files and documenting the learning and the result. This phase consists of two things: contract closure and project close. Contract closure includes complete and settlement of each contract and close each contract applicable to the project or project phase. Project close includes the finalization of activities across all of the process groups to formally close the project or a project phase. Next topic is triple constraints. Different project management tools are available to perform this traditional approach technique. Any project revolves around three main and basic factors which are most essential for product management: scope, time, and cost. Scope includes project size, goals, and requirements. Time includes task duration, dependencies. and money includes or cost includes cost, contingencies and profit. Other than this, resources are also important, which includes people, equipment and materials.
So let us now understand what project management tools are. These are tools that can help us manage project easily and efficiently. In these tools, we can define the project plan and task. This helps us to monitor and evaluate progress easily. In these tools, we can manage the budget and the time. We can analyze the risk. We can also communicate and collaborate with others. A standard project management tool must have a Gantt chart, a logic network, PERT chart, product breakdown structure, work breakdown structure. Examples of some project management tools are Trello, Scoro, WorkZone, Notion, Workbook, Productive and Friedkin. So let us understand what Trello actually is. With Trello, we can organize cards. In this, the cards can be thoughts, cards can be conversation, or we also have a to-do list in Trello. There are Gantt chart available in Trello, and all these can be placed in a board through which everyone can collab and work on it. Why Trello? It has all the standard features of project management tools. It is free and consists of full featured. It also has a mobile app, and the UI of Trello is simple but attractive. It's easy to sign up to. Trello plugin. With Trello plugin, we can improve our graphs. There are many Trello plugins, but developer mainly uses Placer for Gantt chart, Corello for agile chart, and Harvest for detailed time tracking. This is what Trello looks like. It enables us to categorize cards into different categories like not started, started, and completed. It also shows task deadline and keep a log of each user action and activities performed by different users. Product management tools helps product developers to manage large projects efficiently and keep a track of every product activities periodically. This was just a short discussion about product management and management tools. You can learn more about different management tools that are popular and often used by visiting the mentioned link. Thank you.